Animals are a whole lot smarter than we give them credit for, but we still think it's okay to lock them in cages and charge astronomical fees to stare at them. And they don't seem to like that. Join us as we have a look at 8 times that all mayhem broke out at zoos. Ken Allen and the Orangutan. As it turns out, even orangutans can have mortal enemies, as silly as it may seem. They're more like humans than we could possibly ever imagine. One 250-pound orangutan has gained worldwide fame for his daring escapes. He climbed up his retaining wall at the San Diego Zoo and managed to escape his exhibit in 1985. He then walked down a public path toward crowds, even stopping to look at some of the other animals in their enclosures as if it were just another day at the zoo for him. He would then be quietly led back to his own cage, and it wouldn't be the first or the last time that Ken Allen escaped. And in the aftermath, he became somewhat of a legend in San Diego. The zoo even added more security to his pen, but didn't seem to be enough to contain this adventure-seeking orangutan, because just a few weeks later, he climbed the wall again. Zookeepers found him in front of an ape enclosure, throwing rocks at Otis, a fellow orangutan. The two were not exactly friends, if it wasn't obvious. Ken would be brought back to his enclosure once again, but then escaped after he found a crowbar in his pen that workers had left behind. He then tossed it at another orangutan, who used it to pry open a window to let Ken out. They're pretty clever if they go through all that just to escape. After this escape, Ken would be moved to a temporary indoor pen and given a black and white television with one working channel. It was an upgrade which he did seem to enjoy. Escaping did seem to be his favorite activity, though even when he was first rescued from his mother, who wanted to smother him, zookeepers discovered that he had a keen interest in unscrewing the bolts of his cage. He would put everything back together each morning to make it look like nothing had ever happened. The zoo became so obsessed with containing Ken that they ended up spending over $45,000 on new security measures, and that's when the escapes would finally end. Up to that point, Ken had managed to escape a total of 9 times, and crowds would even cheer him on with every breakout. Ken then would be diagnosed with a rare form of B-cell lymphoma and had to be euthanized in December of 2000, but a memorial was put up for him and a vigil would be held in his honor. 3 Monkeys. This next one is a plot for a conventionally well-written cartoon where 3 crested macaques stage a breakout while the zoo is closed because of a national red alert storm warning in Ireland. It does sound like it could be a real hit, but too bad the Penguins of Madagascar already exists and they didn't use these brilliant monkeys instead. The monkeys in question would make a 20-foot jump onto a fence after the roof would be blown off of their enclosure. And then they were located in a nearby tree where they safely returned home. Now, they were probably confused when they realized that the trees in Ireland looked nothing like the ones in their enclosure and decided not to venture out any farther. They did, however, manage to climb 65 feet above ground and into the tree, but then were all shot at with tranquilizer darts. Fortunately, the storm was on the monkeys' sides, and none of the shots would hit them due to the high winds and the branches of the trees being in the way. We can't even imagine the chaos that would ensue, but the monkeys did finally surrender, climbing down the trees 2 hours later. They were then returned safely to their enclosures after a thorough examination. Satara the Rhino. No one said that it was easy to get older, especially if you're going to get left for a younger and better-looking person. But this 2-ton white rhino named Satara got to experience everything like this firsthand. He even went on a jealous rampage in order to show his disgust, all after discovering that his mate had been paired with a younger male. The bull escaped his enclosure in the middle of the night and sparked a search around the zoo. Satara had been paired with Yura, a female, but couldn't quite complete the task, although he had fathered Yura's first baby. The zoo staff finally tracked Satara and had to shoot him with 5 tranquilizer darts throughout the day just in order to get him back to the zoo safely. A few of the shots would bounce off the rhino, but thankfully, they were all able to get him back into the enclosure without anything going wrong. The escape was thought to be a display of male rivalry. It was speculated that he was most likely able to smell what was happening, and his instinct to take down the male would have been extremely powerful. Fortunately, the stone walls inside the zoo would keep him inside, but it was the wooden ones around the rhino pen that he managed to escape through. It was probably also a good thing that it happened in the middle of the night, so that things could be quickly fixed without anyone in the zoo getting hurt or any animals being killed. A sweet ride to Freedom Highway. One clever macaw by the name of Chuva already had her wings clipped, but it didn't mean that she couldn't come up with other ways to escape the Greater Vancouver Zoo and go on her own little adventure. A family would spot the 6-year-old bird under an RV and were surprised by her, to say the least. As it turns out, Chuva had disappeared from the zoo's parrot gardens, but no one really knew exactly how she'd escaped the facility. She turned out to be extremely hungry and thirsty when she was returned to the zoo, but was in good shape for the adventure that she had decided to go on. Chuva lived in a facility with her mother and father, and they were very vocal when she was returned home, probably yelling at her in macaw for her rebellious antics, but who really knows? Maybe they were just excited that she'd been returned safely, because macaws don't usually choose to be stowaways. Nakisa the Hippo. Gardens are usually the prime location for birds, bees, and the occasional rabbit, but who would really ever expect to go out and see a giant 2-ton hippopotamus basking in the sun in their garden? We can't say that we wouldn't love the idea of it, because it turns out that Nakisa regularly escapes his pen, and he's the only living hippopotamus in Montenegro. He's made his home at the zoo for over a decade, but if floods hit the area, he will often escape because the water gets too high. Nakisa is tame and doesn't really want to harm anyone, and the locals have become accustomed to seeing him floating about after a storm. Most of the time, Nakisa is easy to get back into his pen after the water is back to normal, and it's probably because he knows it will only be a matter of time until his next great adventure, where he can swim freely about the town with stunned onlookers watching his every move. A vulture mauled by lions. There is such a thing as getting too close and personal with zoo animals, and we're sure that's exactly how people that were visiting the Colchester Zoo in England felt. It was an extremely windy day during the falcon display, and the trainers knew that they had to do something different with the vulture. As it turns out, though, the bird had another idea in mind, and it was ready to make the great escape. It ended up getting its feet caught in the net of a lion's den, and that's when a female lion ripped the bird through the net and made a meal out of it. Zookeepers tried to clear the area of visitors as quickly as possible, but many people saw what had happened because it was so instantaneous. Sure, it would be a scary sight to see, but it's also natural in the wild. And if you were on a safari, you might just experience something like this, especially since there aren't any nets dividing the animals. It may have traumatized some children from going to the zoo anytime soon, though. Leona the Penguin. Now, this one could have ended up as a real disaster, because Leona was only a few months old and was already bored with her normal zoo routine. One day, she would decide to go for a little adventure, cutely waddling into the lion's den of a zoo in Germany. This adventurous penguin escaped from its pool, and then took a wrong turn, but fortunately for her, a visitor would spot the 3-month-old, and it seemed as though the family of lions nearby didn't pose a threat because they were all fast asleep. The penguin was in danger because she had become trapped under some ice, but fortunately a zookeeper was able to lure her out with some fish, and she even earned herself a name. Most of the penguins were assigned numbers, but for this daring girl, she was given the name Leona, a stark contrast from her assigned number of 459. The Great Egyptian Cobra Escape. For some, it may have been more like a Harry Potter nightmare gone terribly wrong. But it turns out that the great Egyptian cobra who escaped his reptilian habitat at the New York City Zoo quickly slithered into the hearts of Twitter fans everywhere. The zoo quickly conducted an around-the-clock search for the 3-ounce, 20-inch-long snake as soon as it was discovered that it had escaped. Eventually, the snake would be lured out after zoo officials sprinkled some wood shavings across the area that mice and rats had made bedding in order to lure it out with its sense of smell. The wood shavings had the scent of rodents, which would have appeared to be dinner to the cobra, and the cobra was quickly intrigued. She was, after all, probably famished after having such a great adventure. The zoo would reopen the reptile house, but the snake earned media attention, especially after the launch of an anonymous @BronxZoo'sCobra Twitter feed. The feed would toy with New Yorkers who feared snakes with a bit of funny tweets. Some of them included, "City may not sleep, but I'm ready to." "Oh, a chimney. I bet you bragged to your friends about having a working fireplace in New York City. Hi, roomie." However, there were also silly tweets that played up to the humor of the account. As it turns out, the snake had a lot of wit and charm, but she's now safe and cozy back in her cage for the time being. Oh, and we're also betting that New Yorkers are sleeping a lot better at night, knowing that she is where she's supposed to be, locked up, safe and tight. The blue-ringed octopus. When first thinking about deadly ocean creatures, you probably get the theme to Jaws stuck in your head. However, sharks aren't the only thing in the water that can be deadly to humans. This member of the octopus family can actually kill a person just as easily as a stingray or a shark. The blue-ringed octopus has a natural defense mechanism that causes the blue rings surrounding its body to light up. If you ignore those rings, you're probably going to succumb to the blue-ringed octopus's other natural defense. Because